At the end of this online module, you should be able to concatenate arrays. So what does concatenate mean? According to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary, concatenate means to join things together in a series or chain. In MATLAB, that can be very useful for arrays. Concatenating arrays means to join arrays together. There are many instances for which we may need to concatenate arrays, which means we will take two or more individual arrays and join them together into one array. So let's learn about concatenation of arrays through a problem that may face an engineer coding in MATLAB. An engineer is working on the design of a treadmill and needs to better understand the speed at which users start their workout. Distance and time data have been provided for three different users using a treadmill at resistance level 7. These data exist in individual arrays by user. The engineer wants to combine them into one array for further analysis. Concatenation for these data can happen in two ways: side-by-side concatenation or stacked concatenation. Let's consider side-by-side concatenation first. One way the engineer might want to combine the data into a single array is to place the data side-by-side. Note that in order to do this in MATLAB, all of the matrices that need to be concatenated should have the same number of rows. In MATLAB, the separate arrays of data for user 1, user 2, and user 3 have already been entered. I can concatenate the individual arrays together into a single array I will call user_data_SBS for side-by-side. In order to concatenate arrays side-by-side, I use the same notation as I would for assigning a row vector. Between brackets, I list my variables with either spaces or commas separating them. Just as with the assignment of a row vector, this places the element inside the brackets side-by-side. When I hit enter, notice that my result is a new matrix of size 4x6 that has the user 1 data in columns 1 and 2, the user 2 data in columns 3 and 4, and the user 3 data in columns 5 and 6. As a side note, there is a built-in MATLAB function called horscat that also concatenates arrays side by side. Now, what should we do if we want the data stacked? Let's consider stacked concatenation. Another way the engineer might want to combine the data into a single array is to place the data one below the other. In this format, the engineer might also want to keep track of the user to which the data belongs. I added another column indicating user to the matrix on the right. So how do we do this in MATLAB? Again, notice that the user data is already entered in MATLAB in three separate arrays named by user. Now I will concatenate the smaller arrays together into a single variable I call user_data_stack. To employ stacked concatenation, I use the same notation as I would for assigning a column vector. Between brackets, I list my variables with semicolons separating them. Just as with the assignment of a column vector, this places the elements one below the other. As a side note, you can also stack arrays using the built-in MATLAB function called vertcat. Notice that when I press enter, I just have the data for the users, but I cannot tell which user is which. To add the user number column to the array, I need to first create the column of 1s, 2s, and 3s to match the user indicated. There is a variety of approaches I could take to do this, but for simplicity, and because my data set is small, I am just going to hard code the column vector. I will name it user_no. NO is an abbreviation for number. I will make a vector of 4 1s, 4 2s, and 4 3s, as there are 4 sets of data points for each user. See that I didn't include semicolons between the numbers, so that will make this a row vector. It needs to be a column vector, so I will transpose the vector using the dot apostrophe syntax. Finally, I can use side-by-side concatenation to add the user number column onto the existing stacked data variable by calling my variable user_data_stack and replacing it with the side-by-side concatenation by opening a bracket, typing user_no for the first element, and user_data_stack for the second element, then closing my bracket. Notice that in MATLAB, it is possible to replace a variable value using the same variable name if it already exists. So this line of code can be thought of as the new user data stack will now be equal to a new matrix that has the first column user no, and the remaining columns have the values from the old user data stack. To summarize this module, When concatenating arrays, they must have the same dimension in the directions they are being concatenated. That is, if the arrays are being put side by side, then they need to have the same number of rows. And if the arrays are being stacked on top of one another, they need to have the same number of columns. When using side-by-side concatenation, the syntax is similar to that of row vectors. Each array to be concatenated is separated by a space or a comma. And finally, when using stacked concatenation, the syntax is similar to that of column vectors. Each array to be concatenated is separated by a semicolon.